Styles, Mo T.
B96 hanging out right now on the Comcast couch. We got them. And ladies, if you look out the window, they're screaming out there, man. We got Plies in the building. How are you, man?
Hey, family, how you doing, man? I'm glad to be here.
Yeah, welcome to Chi-Town, dude.
Hey, I want to tell you, kind of a ritual of mine. I kind of like to try to do it. I just want to thank the both of you. Also, B96, man, for giving me the opportunity to not only come to the Chi-Town, but to have the opportunity to graze the airwaves, man, and thank the people that support my situation so much.
I don't think we've ever had anyone like say that off the bat. That was really cool, man. It shows that you're a humble dude.
I'm trying to continue to be that way. I tried to take my way through life. That didn't get me far. I tried to be respectful in life, and it got me farther than I ever been. So
that's cool, man.
I just want to make sure I try to.
Well, it's really cool.
Right off the gate, I'm in love with your new song, dude. Busted Baby, love this song, okay? Featuring Neo. Now, explain to me, because I'm conflicted about it. What does Busted Baby mean? Because it's a beautiful song, beautiful hook, beautiful, everything's cool. What does it mean?
Actually, it's a term that I used on my last album, The Real Testament. Never thought it was going to be a national term.
Uh-huh.
Record is amazing, but to answer the question, it's answered the politically correct way.
give us the dirty version.
No, I probably won't be welcome back here after that.
Right.
Actually, it's what I like to call your best female significant other.
Okay.
In terms of maybe on an intimate level, I guess.
Okay. So it's kind of like a booty call girl?
It has a little more class than that. Yeah. It's what you, like I said, it's what you would like to call your best female encounter, should
Can
I say.
Can you have a lot of these encounters?
Yeah, your best means there's others?
It's only one best, though.
Only one best, right?
I would think it's only one best.
If we ever get girlfriends, I doubt our girls will ever go for that at all. See, you're the best one of all of them.
You have a different way of approaching, of looking at things. Like, you take the cool route of doing it. We just take the... Like, we're going to get in trouble. Like, the girl's going to delete her number out of the phones.
I think if you're telling her she's the best, I don't think she'll have a problem with that.
That's a good point.
Yeah, but come on, the best of all my other girls? You really think that...
I think that's why she would be your girl.
Okay, right. All right, well, anyways, let's move along, man. You've had a lot of success in a short period of time, man. I mean, Hypnotize is a song that we played over and over and over again. Let me ask you a question. How did you get... I mean, we're talking about, okay, Akon on Hypnotize, Neo on Busted Baby, a lot of other cameos. How did you get all these great big superstars on your records being, you know what I'm saying, you haven't been in the game for 10, 15 years?
Right. I'd like to tell you, no better way, it's a blessing.
Mm-hmm. Right.
To have the opportunity to work with T-Pain on Shorty, the first national look that I had. I do understand how blessed of an individual that I am, and that's why it's easy for me to stay humble, because I had the pleasure of working with, whether it was from T-Pain to Akon on Hypnotize to now Neo, they're legendary people in the game, in my opinion.
For sure.
And also one of the three hardest working individuals that I've ever come across, and I have the opportunity to be a part of their situation, not only respecting me from an artist perspective, but also kind of, I was able to earn my stripes with them a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
And kind of, a lot of those dudes knew about my underground situation, mm-hmm. like in the Southeast region, for the last 5.5-6 years. So it's a true blessing, man. And my second single, actually, I just got off the phone with Atlantic, and we just confirmed that situation, and it's some more star-studded, I guess.
Who is it?
Appearances. The record is called Please Excuse My Hands.
Okay. Nice.
And it has Dream on the record, as well as Jamie Foxx. So.
What are you excusing in that?
My hands on the record?
Yeah, my hands. I'm just telling you, just please excuse my hands. Sometimes they...
Does that work if you tell the person first off, please excuse them, and then...
I think it justifies it a little bit. I don't think I think if it's a certain way, you have to do it. But I think the record was clever. It was a record, actually, when I had the opportunity to play around with it in the studio. I just thought it was so different in terms of any other record that I've ever heard. For you to tell a female to please excuse my hands, like, you can't control them.
What makes you so different? I mean, like, I've listened to hip-hop music my entire life, and I mean, let's be real, a lot of it is very, a lot of it can be derogatory toward women. And here you are just like, blessing and you know, it's my woman. Like, you're very, very, very respectful and polite. Explain that, how you came to that, obviously growing up with hip-hop.
For me, bro, it's kind of simple. I don't try to follow the trends of hip-hop.
You yourself. Sometimes
I get flack for making the female-driven records, but it's kind of crazy to me. Like, I tell people all the time, I'm not mad all the time. So
yeah, right.
I don't make all mad music.
Mm-hmm.
And then, two, I'm not on that female side all the time neither. I don't try to find a median. I just try to do music that's true to me.
Uh-huh.
But in retrospect, I think a lot of times I just talk out loud through my music what a lot of people are thinking. And whether it's a Shorty record, whether it's a Hypnotize record, I think we all at some point in our life seen a particular.
You get a lot
female.
Of girls for this, don't you?
Yeah, right.
Now let's be for real.
I'm trying to.
This is guy
to,
locker room talk right now. You get a lot of girls out of this, don't you?
For me, bro, it's weird because to answer your question, yeah. But at the same time, I feel like I kind of approach my life a little different because I do understand that it's someone around this country, on the female side that is sitting at home, and if they got an opportunity to destroy my life, they would.
Okay.
And for me to understand that, I kind of approach my life that way. Like, I know everyone that claims that they're a fan of my situation doesn't always mean me the best. So, for me, I embrace it. I love it. I think from a male perspective, who wouldn't want to have, you know, a huge female following as an artist? But at the same time, I'm real careful about it because I do understand that I'm one mistake away, bro, from this whole situation going down the drain.
He's
so.
Sponsored by Trojans, by the way, which is really cool. No, for real. No, so, you know what? You know you're a big star when you're in the tabloids. You know you're in the you know, tabloids, Perez Hilton, all these kind of things. We're in a magazine, Hip Hop Weekly, Plies linked to Brandy.
Situation, actually. I just got a whiff of it. Yesterday, actually.
Here's a magazine. You want to read it?
While I was in Chicago.
It's funny because it's got a picture of you and Neo.
And you know what, bro? Is to be the caliber guy that I try to be anyway, that's the part of the industry that I think I would never, ever be cool with.
Right.
That someone can wake up out of nowhere with a story that is 100%. Totally false. Like, I never had the pleasure or the luxury of even meeting Brandy. Like,
how can they print that? And I mean, here, you know, Plies and Brandy. How can they just do that? You never even met her before.
I never, like, if you asked me if I thought that she knew me, I'd probably tell you no.
Wow.
Like, I know her from a distance in terms of the celebrity that she is. And it's weird, bro. And it's sad to me that publications are that thirsty. Like, you don't even care. Yeah.
But the good thing about it is, it's not a bad look for you. I mean, Brandy's not bad on the eyes.
Nah, she's not. But for me, I don't know what her situation is. Like, she may be in a relationship, and that may be a strain on her relationship. Like, I don't know if she's dating.
But it's nothing that you can do. I mean, it's not like you called this magazine and said, hey, get me in this magazine. I want to hook up with Brandy. I want to be with Rihanna, you know, blah, blah, blah. Hey, but it's just funny because you got the single out right now featuring Neo.
Exactly.
And, you know, and they put you two against each other and
with
this
Brandy. Magazine, which is garbage, man. It's garbage. Garbage.
And for me, bro, I'm so sold on my morals, my values, and my beliefs. I'm that willing to not do business with particular publications that don't take the time out to find out if a story is really true or not before you actually print it. And that's the part of this business that I do understand. Success has its pros and it has its cons.
Mm-hmm.
And for me, I just take life too serious to read things that are 100% not true by no stretch of imagination.
So has anything you ever woken up or have you opened up a magazine and you saw it and it really upset you?
I think early on, it was probably a couple things. But at the same time, bro, I feel honestly I could tell you if I let that kind of stuff really irritate me, then I'm fighting a losing battle.
Exactly.
I know it's easy sometimes to read things. But at the same time, bro, I think it's so many more important things that going on that happens in the world that people really want to hear about.
Mm-hmm.
And it's sad that we live in a society that if you're not famous, you're really non-avoid.
Mm-hmm.
And it's crazy because, you know, it's people that die every day around the country, but it takes you to be a celebrity that it becomes national news when you lose a family member.
Mm-hmm. Right. You know, it's a good point, for sure. And I would have never expected this at all, Plies, by the way. I mean, I would have never expected, you know, you got some hot records and stuff like that, but yeah, you're very, very deep and very, very morally sound.
I appreciate it.
You know,
I feel, bro, this industry, I don't know. It was built for what I like to call dumb artists.
Mm-hmm.
You know, they teach you at Atlantic Records. They give you a media prep course, like it's media training. But
because it's tough out there,
right? But at the same time, what I look as to be the contradiction is they never sent me to a class to teach me the business of the music industry. So you care about me not embarrassing your brand. But you don't care if I really know this business or not.
Yeah, right. So they're going to try to milk some money out of you You know what I mean? But not giving you the proper knowledge of signing a contract
right.
or something like that or right. making, you know, money by writing the
right.
lyrics
you,
and stuff
you,
like that.
You allow that to be my responsibility.
For sure.
And for me, I feel on the other end, you'll pay for me to do media training.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't not only embarrass myself, but embarrass your well. Brand.
Right, that's a good point. You know what?
The
all you can do
in,
is
though.
Keep on making hot records. And again, the new single is Plies featuring Neo, Busta Baby. I love the song. Great, great song. Plies, pleasure to have you right here, man. Plies in the house with Styles.
Yes, thank you so much, bro. I appreciate 96. You guys. Thanks, man. I appreciate it.
B96.